Entering Friday night's 4-1 win over the Buffalo Sabres, the Florida Panthers rode a 5-game losing streak. Potted with the holes of a leaky defense and speckled with an inconsistent penalty kill, the road to the bottom of the Eastern Conference was a treacherous one for Florida through the season's first month. The Panthers weren't supposed to be in the conference's cellar. Not after winning a division title 2 seasons ago. Not after last season's disappointing disaster couldn't even push the Panthers into last place. Friday's win in Buffalo gave the Panthers a rope to climb out of the hole, the first victory in 15 days. "It's been a while since we won one," Panthers goaltender Roberto Luongo said. "The first win is always the toughest one to get coming out of a slump." Panthers defenseman Ian McCoshen netted the game-winning goal less than 4 minutes into the third period with a shot from the blue line to lift Florida. Aleksander Barkov pushed his way into Sabres goaltender Robin Lehner's sight, opening up a shooting lane for McCoshen's wrist shot. It was McCoshen's third goal of the season, tying him with Aaron Ekblad for the team lead among defensemen. McCoshen, a rookie, is generally regarded as a defensive defenseman. Of Jenny Dadanov also scored a goal for the Panthers, burying a rebound of Barkov's shot with 13:08 remaining in the second period. It was the first time Florida's top line scored since losing to Tampa Bay on October 30, having gone scoreless the last 3 games. Barkov and Vincent Trocheck each added empty net goals to ice the game. "Right now, we know how we need to play and how we can win," Barkov said. Sabres forward Kyle Okposo tipped in a shot from the point on a Buffalo power play in the first period. It was the fourth time in the last 5 games that the Panthers have given up a power play goal to their opponent. During 2-week absence, Roberto Luongo regains structure, returns sharp for Panthers. The Panthers' defense, that allowed 48 shots on goal during a loss to Carolina on Tuesday, was dramatically different on Friday night. Buffalo didn't fire its 20th shot on goal until Friday's third period. The Hurricanes did it in 1 period on Tuesday. "It was probably our best defensive game of the year," Luongo said. "We kept them really quiet for about 50 minutes. Instead, Florida controlled play for portions of Friday's game, including a sequence in the second period, while on the power play. Jonathan Huberdeau collected the puck down low and spun it towards the open area in front of the crease. But Dadanov couldn't get a stick on it. Neither could a crashing Barkov. Lehner covered up for a sprawling save." The Panthers had 15 shots on goal in the second period alone on Friday night. The Sabres' threats came few and far between. But Luongo came up big in the third period, making a huge save on Sam Reinhart that kept the game tied. Luongo made 24 saves in the game. With the win, Luongo passed Curtis Joseph for sole possession of fourth place on the all-time wins list. Luongo now has 455 victories, but he discounted the significance of climbing the all-time wins list. "Through rough start, Panthers GM Dale Tallon stresses patience. It's a project. These accomplishments are for a rainy day, when you're sitting at home and not doing much. For right now, I think the focus is on getting some points in the standings and winning some games and getting into the playoffs." As Luongo donned the New Zealand rugby jersey as the player of the game, he got a whiff of it. "This thing smells nice," he quipped. Through the Panthers' first month under new coach Bob Bonner, the losses have come in a variety of ways. They've masked themselves in decent performances against the 2-time defending champion Pittsburgh Penguins. They've come in debacles against Tampa Bay and Columbus that saw Florida allow 15 total goals. They've even come despite Herculean efforts from their stars, like a 10-point effort from the top line against the Lightning, and their goaltenders, like Roberto Luongo's 45-save game against the Hurricanes. "It's been a rollercoaster," Bowner said before Friday's game. The first 2 games of the Panthers' current road trip looked to be the vaccine for whatever ailed Florida. Carolina lost 4 straight games before playing the Panthers. Florida was the only team in the Eastern Conference with fewer points than Buffalo. The Panthers collected 2 points in the 2 games. They play New Jersey on Saturday night. A loss on Friday night would have tied the longest losing streak from a season ago for the Panthers, a six-game skid down the stretch of last year. "We've been in a few of these games that haven't gone our way," Bonner said. "I think tonight, that'll help us mentally moving forward."